Alright guys, we are still on Across Nigeria, what is happening across Nigeria, and today remains the 22nd day in the month of March 2020, and it's a beautiful Sunday morning, so let me use this opportunity to wish you guys a happy Sunday. I know most of you will be in the church, and some of us will be at home, you know, streaming live. But that is by the way, we all know we are still on the battle with this deadly Chinese virus that succeeded to enter Nigeria without a valid visa. So the government has been making different measures and effort to contain this disease. Example, by shutting down schools, clubs, social gathering, and so on. Well, the question I was asking was, what is going to happen to the market? And we all know that the market square, it's also a crowded place, but we are yet to, you know, get directive from the government what's going to happen in the market. I believe for now some people must have piled up food stuff. Okay, trust Nigerians, I know some people must have piled up their food stuff. Believe me, I will get mine tomorrow, so that is my plan, because nobody knows what's gonna happen next. Okay, so technically speaking, or the bottom line is, Nigeria is gonna be on a shutdown, a lockdown. Okay, but today's been Sunday, Bishop David Oyedepo, the General Overseer of Living Faith Church, also known as Winners Chapel, has criticized the government over the closure of schools in Nigeria. I know a lot of you will be wondering, why is it of recent? Oyedepo has been a government critic ever since this social media bill came up. Okay, he has been a government critic of recent. Yeah, it is okay, we are in a democratic government, everyone is entitled to give their own point of view. Okay, no one owns Nigeria. Nigeria is owned by all of us, so everybody should have their own say. But that is by the way. Now most states in Nigeria as at Friday ordered the closure of schools till further notice as the country battles the spread of this coronavirus. Also, Lagos State Government Council gathering of more than 20 persons after new cases were recorded yesterday Saturday, bringing a total number of I think about 25 or 26 in Nigeria. But Oyedepo, who held the service on Sunday and shunned government directive, okay, on religious gatherings, said the closure of schools was not a right decision by government in curbing the spread of this virus. Okay, so I want you guys to react to this. Now, irrespective of our religious belief or political affiliation, let us look at this squarely. Okay, so I want you guys to contribute on the comment section below. Now, Oyedepo said the directive by the government, okay, is not a good approach in curbing the spread of this virus. According to him, the only disease that has no cure is hunger. Well, we already know that hunger is order of the day in Nigeria. All of us have experienced it. Me, myself, talking to you, I am experiencing hunger. So na hunger bela I carry the talk, so safe. Okay, Oyedepo said, may God help our policy makers to make the right decision in finding solution to this scourge called coronavirus. How can you close school and ask them to go home? You are sending them to where they are more secure, to where they would be exposed to the disease. You are sending them away from where they are not more than 20 back home to go and sell pepper for their mothers in the market where there are more people. You block people from having access to malls in the name of preventing a disease But you don't know that the only disease that doesn't have cure is hunger. Well, for me, I that really got my attention. Oyedepo said the only disease, let us look at it this way. He said the only disease that doesn't have cure is hunger. Man, I really want to choke, put my mouth here, because believe me, in Nigeria, even Oyedepo, let us not forget about sentiment here. Yes, let us forget about sentiment. Do you know that Oyedepo, his family, his generation, for the next years will not understand what hunger is all about? I don't know if you guys will support me. I don't know if you guys will not, but I am telling you the truth. I'm giving you my mind. Okay? The same people that are telling us, telling the Nigerian, telling the federal government that the only disease that doesn't have hunger is, that the only disease that doesn't have cure is hunger. These are the same people that feed at their beck and call. I mean, what are you telling Nigerians? Okay? Now, let us take a typical example, Oyedepo himself. Let us take a typical example about Oyedepo himself. Do you think that Oyedepo, any member of his family, even though the country is on lockdown, will ever experience what hunger is all about? He will not. His family member will not. Yes, we all know that. We all understand that. Let us leave sentiment apart and talk the truth whenever we see one. All right? Now, the government is trying their best, looking on some measures how to contain this virus. Now, the only avenue where this disease can spread faster is social gathering, like the church, the clubs, and so on. Now, take a look at this. We all know how this virus is transmitted through droplets. All right. Now, I don't want to mention some church. I don't want to mention any church name. Imagine going to a church and they say, turn to your neighbor and pray. Fire, fire, fire. As you are shouting fire, we all know what is coming out from your mouth. And looking at the space, the crowded area, and fire, die, fire, die, fire. What do you expect? So these are the measures the government is trying to avoid the spread of this disease. So I really don't see any sense with what Oyedepo is saying. I'm only telling you my own point of view. I'm reacting to this, okay? So you can also put your own contribution on the comment section below, all right? So Oyedepo said the only hunger, or the only disease that doesn't have cure, is hunger. Believe me, let me not get so emotional when I am talking about this. Well, according to Oyedepo, he said, may God help our leaders to make the right decision in search of solution to this pandemic. All right. Well, according to Oyedepo, he had earlier said that the cure for this disease will be out soon, and the nation will rejoice. All right. So that is the update I have for you guys. Let me allow you to put in some contribution here, because what really got my attention was when Oyedepo said the only policy, that this is not the right approach the government should use in containing this disease. But I believe I have to disagree with this. Yes, I have to disagree with this. Now, imagine, I'm not saying, just imagine, okay, a member of his church is infected with coronavirus, and today, Sunday, believe me or not, somebody inside the church, one or two people, will go home with that disease, with that virus. Take it or you leave it. That is my own personal opinion. All right. So let me know what you think on the comment section below. For me, I really don't justify this. I really don't agree with Oyedepo. Alright, I'm only reacting to this. I'm not criticizing. I don't criticize government. I don't criticize clerics. I only say what I feel it is reality. Alright, that is what I believe. I'm not this religion type. Alright, so I really don't see this as I really don't see this. I am not agreeing with what Oyedepo said here, that the whole, yeah, we all know that hunger in Nigeria is the order of the day. Most of us, yeah, already Nigerians is living, most of Nigerians live with $1 daily, all right? They live with $1 daily. So we all know there's hunger, okay, unemployment. It happens to every other countries. It is there in other countries, okay? But when it comes to issue of this coronavirus, like I said, if only the members of those churches will go back to history, read about Spanish flu in 1918, believe me, people will be careful. People will be careful how they even listen to the advice of their religious leader. This is not the time. Daddy Free says this year go rugged. This is not the time. Alright? This is not the time. If the government approach, yeah, China took the same approach. They locked down the city. Italy is taking the same approach. They locked down the city. Alright? If this is the approach where government will use in containing this disease, I really don't see anything wrong with that. Yeah, we already know that hunger is the order of the day, so it shouldn't justify your gathering. The federal government is not against your gathering. The federal government is not against your businesses, okay? The federal government is only concerned about the life of their citizens, because they swore to an oath to protect the life and property of their citizens. So bringing in sentiment and religion, all right, to to criticize the government policy, I really don't support that. Yeah, you guys know me, I'm not affiliated to any political party. I only talks about reality. All right, so that is it. Let me not waste your time. I'll see you guys in another video, but don't forget to subscribe. It's part of your effort to support my ministry. All of us, the hustle, all right? Part of your effort to support me is for you to subscribe and also turn on the bell icon so you get instant notification whenever I have stories like this to share with you guys. Happy Sunday. I will see you guys in another video. And don't forget, most of those charges, you can live stream them. How I wish the government will make available unlimited data plan for us so we can live stream. So that would be my own appeal, if they are shutting down churches, so we can always live stream from our house. But the question is, how are you gonna pay your tithe and how are you gonna give your offering? So I believe that could be the reason why plenty people will criticize government, okay, when they remember tithe and offering. Yeah, it is quite unfortunate that they have to criticize the government for the approach they are making to contain this deadly disease. All right guys, I will see you in another video.